breaking right now. A local soldier is headed to prison. No chance of parole. A military jury has just sentenced Staff Sergeant Robert Bales. He admits to killing 16 Afghan villagers, many of them kids, last year, and yesterday speaking out in court, calling his own actions an act of cowardice. The 40-year-old went to Norwood High School. Back in June, he pleaded guilty to this massacre in a deal to avoid the death penalty.
Yeah, Robert Bales showed no emotion as the verdict was announced today at Joint Base Lewis McCord, that's south of Seattle. WLWT News 5's Jackie Canjado is leading the way tonight with the breaking details in this case. Jackie?
Mike and Sheree, as you mentioned, Robert Bales played football here for Norwood High School back in the 90s, and people who knew him at the time just cannot make sense of how this happened. And Robert Bales himself has never offered an explanation for why he went on that killing mission. Yesterday, he took the witness stand and apologized. Before that, the jury heard testimony from 9 Afghans flown in for the trial, including one man who lost 6 of 7 children, as well as his wife and mother. Bales went on the rampage through 2 poor villages in Kandahar. Despite Bales' sentence of life without parole, the victims do not think that's enough.
I have a request from the American people that there should be an accountability. Even if somebody shoots a sheep, they have to answer, why was the sheep shot? In our country, humans are being shot, humans are being imprisoned, and yet you can't ask. There's no justice, there's no ramification for that.
Bales is a father of 2. He was on his 4th tour overseas. His lawyers have said that he was suffering from post-traumatic stress disorder and from a traumatic brain injury, and his mother was sitting in the front row today. She bowed her head and cried as that verdict was read. Reporting live in Norwood tonight, Jackie Canjado, WLWT News 5.
Jackie, thank you. Now, this massacre prompted angry protests in Afghanistan and the temporary suspension of U.S. combat operations. Villagers have said that the families of the victims were paid a total of about $700,000.